Welcome back. Now, a few words on immunité rationnée matérielle of foreign officials. Immunité rationnée matérielle does not exist out of the fact that the foreign official embodies, personally embodies, the state, which is the reason for the immunité rationnée personnée, knowing that the latter stands as long as the person is a high-level representative of the foreign state. Rather, immunité rationnée matérielle exists because the act of the official is attributed to the state, and the state itself enjoys immunity from jurisdiction. The reason for immunité rationnée matérielle is that the acts of the state official is attributed to the state, and that if the state itself is immune from jurisdiction, its representative should be also immune. Otherwise, one could get at the state through its representative. Immunité rationnée matérielle is also called official acts immunity. As the UN Convention on Jurisdictional Immunities of States and Their Property recalls, it is usually not disputed that all representatives of the state acting in that capacity enjoy immunité rationnée matérielle for the official acts so performed, even if they have acted ultra vires. Representatives of states include, of course, the head of state, head of government, and foreign affairs ministers referred to earlier, as well as diplomats of the state. However, in contrast with what is required for triggering immunité rationnée personnée, the concept of representatives of the state for the purpose of immunité rationnée matérielle is not limited to persons specifically embodying or personifying the state. Rather, that concept encompasses all state organs within the meaning of Article 4 of the ILC Articles on State Responsibility, together with, I quote, all the natural persons who are authorized to represent the state in all its manifestations, to use the ILC comments on the UN Convention on State Immunity. Therefore, it makes sense to use the attribution rules that we surveyed during week 6 about international responsibility of states for determining whether the conduct of the state representative was done in an official capacity or a private capacity, knowing that immunité rationnée matérielle only protects official acts. Immunité rationnée matérielle extends to acts iure imperii and acts iure gestionis, provided that they were not performed in a private capacity. Immunité rationnée matérielle continues to exist after the end of the official functions of the representative. And that's a main difference with personae immunity. And for instance, Article 39, too, of the 61 Convention on Diplomatic Relations specifically provides that diplomats continue to benefit from criminal immunity after the end of their accreditation regarding all acts performed in the exercise of their diplomatic functions. Immunité rationnée matérielle is controlled by the foreign state, not only in the sense that it can be waived by that state, like immunité rationnée personnée, but also in the sense that it must be claimed by the foreign state. As the ICJ ruled in the Djibouti versus France case, and I quote, "The state which seeks to claim immunity for one of its state organs is expected to notify the authorities of the other state concerned. This would allow the court of the foreign state to ensure that it does not fail to respect any entitlement to immunity and might thereby engage the responsibility of that state. Further, the state notifying a foreign court that judicial process should not proceed for reasons of immunity against its state organs is assuming responsibility for any internationally wrongful act in issue committed by such organs." It is to be noted that the link established by the court between the claim made by the state in favor of the immunité rationnée matérielle of its representative and its international responsibility does not exist with the same strict necessity as far as immunity rationnée personnée is concerned, as the latter immunity may relate to private acts for which no international responsibility of the state exists. Last but not least, and like immunity rationnée personnée, immunity rationnée matérielle does not apply for the purpose of the ICC jurisdiction between state parties to the statute. In light of all this, the current question is to know whether a state representative can still enjoy immunity rationnée matérielle when accused of crimes in violation of prohibitions enshrined in jus cogens norms. And as we have seen, immunity rationnée personnée is total and absolute and protects even against prosecution relating to such grave breaches. However, immunity rationnée personnée is only temporary and ceases to exist at the end of the official functions, so that it does not result in impunity, but it only postpones to later prosecution for crimes that are usually not subject to a statute of limitations. And by contrast, immunity rationnée matérielle survives after the end of the official functions, and therefore a possible exception to immunity rationnée matérielle for grave breaches seems to be an important element to enhance the fight against impunity. The Pinochet case offers an illustration of such an exception, but it is still debated if that case reflects the current status of customary international law. In the Germany versus Italy case, and you may remember that the court ruled in that case that, I quote, under customary international law as it presently stands, a state is not deprived of immunity by reason of the fact that it is accused of serious violations of international human rights law or the international law of armed conflict, end of quote. And this may indicate that the Pinochet case was wrong and that no exception to immunity rationnée matérielle for state representative exists, even when accused of grave crimes. However, the court emphasized that its conclusion on the issue of state immunity is without prejudice to the question, I quote, the question of whether, and if so, to what extent, immunity might apply in criminal proceedings against an official of the state, end of quote. And let me submit to you that, as in the Pinochet case, exceptions to immunity rationnée matérielle could be grounded in the obligation to prosecute grave crimes enshrined in various treaties. Because such obligation to prosecute exists, the immunity rationnée matérielle, which is otherwise unlimited in time, that immunity should give way between contracting parties.